Okay, folks, it is the 28th of March, 2014, and it's about 10:45 at night, and that's when we're going to fire up the old Philco 37-2670 for the first time. Now, I've got the speaker all wired in, as you can see. I got all the wires. I've got, I've got four wires. I got a yellow, a green, a red, and a black. And those wires run over to the speaker wires. I've got those taped off for safety. You know, there's quite a bit of voltage comes through there. And I've got them all taped off and ready to go. All right, here we go. Unfortunately, the dial is broken. I'll show you that. They had it hooked on. They had it hooked on with a, whoever did it had it hooked on with a piece of electrical tape, and it came off the back. It was glued, and it just came off the back. So I'm going to have to get a whole new dial. This thing's shot to pieces. So we're going to have to go without it for the first test fire. But small price to pay. Small price to pay. Okay, here we go. I'm going to go ahead and turn on the old isolation transformer. Turn down this. And then turn that on. And let's see. This is the volume here. Turn it up. About halfway, I guess, will be about right. We'll put this thing here. Let me see. Maybe if I turn on this light over here, it might help a little. I don't know. Might hinder, actually. Let me see. Oh, my goodness. That thing is really bright. Let me push it over that way. Okay, that's a little better. I want to make the variable capacitor out about halfway, I guess. And let's go ahead and set this up for broadcast band. I think that's the broadcast band position. Here we go. We're turning it on. See, I got the, I hooked up the antenna. I think it's still hooked up. Yeah, the antenna is hooked up. And the ground wire I hooked up, that's correct. All right, moving it around here, getting it ready for the camera. I wanted to make sure I didn't tear anything off. Okay, here we go. Going on. Now we got to keep our eye on the current draw. That's pretty important. Let's move this light off a little bit where we can get a better view of it. Okay, here goes. Let's bring up the voltage. For those of you who have watched me repair radios, you've watched this drill before. We've all gone through this same drill. Well, incidentally, the shadow meter has to be connected into the circuit in order for this thing to work, or these two tubes up here, the 6A8 and the 6K7, won't have any plate voltage. Okay, so it's got to be in the circuit, and the coil has to be good. So here goes. Let's bring it up. All right, we're up to 50 volts. What's going on in the car? Oh my goodness, look at here. Look at here. We have a dial light already. All right, so far so good. We got us a dial light. Now, when you're doing this and you're kind of reaching over and doing things like that, you know, always reach around to the side like I'm doing right here. I don't like to reach over the top of a radio, you know, because there's all kinds of little contacts and things that you could touch. You don't want that to happen. All right, we've got nothing out of our rectifier tube yet. Alright, current draw is very low, very low. Alright, let's take it up to, let me see, 60, 70. Let's take it up 75 volts, see what happens. Current draw is still looking good. We're doing okay. Okay, okay, okay. What am I hearing? What am I hearing? Do you hear that? Do you hear noise, people? I hear noise. I don't believe it. That's 75 volts. Holy mackerel. Look at that. I don't know what it is, but let's bring it up a little bit more. Let's go up to 90 volts. Well, we're getting whistling. What's going on with the current? We're not doing too bad. We're below an amp. We're on the bottom scale, by the way. We're using the bottom scale right here. Zero to 5 amps. Not bad so far. 90 volts. All right, let's go up to 110. 100. You see, there's 100. 5. Let's go up to 110. Uh-oh, is my sound disappearing? I hope not. Current draw is still pretty good. Let me crank up the volume. We got a nice, fairly bright bulb here. Let's turn up the volume. All right, I got the volume all the way up. Not good so far. Crank it back a little bit. All right. At least we got some sound out of it. That's what I wanted. Now, I may have to do a whole bunch of other crap, but we're going to find out here. Here we go. Current draw is good. Watch that current. Watch that current. That's important. We're up to 120. 125 minus about 10 volts makes it about 115, 116. Not bad. Not bad. She's holding. She's holding. All the tubes are lit up. Let's turn off this light. Oh, that's even better yet. All right, all the tubes are lit up. All right. All right, all right, all right, all right. Let's see if we can turn it, tune in the station here. Let's turn up the volume.
Didn't have the guitar player, so...
You know who that is? Do you know who that is? That is WSM out of Nashville. Yes, it is. It's Eddie Stubbs.
Ernest Stubbs never heard from the band or saw him again. He speculated that the guitarist named Eddie Tudor...
All right. Holy mackerel. That looks pretty neat, huh?
...many years of Ronnie Pugh was writing the biography on Ernest Stubbs.
Wow. I'm impressed. I am impressed. How are we doing over here? Still good. Less than an amp. Only about 3/4 of an amp, actually. Voltage showing about 125.
Try me one more time on WSM.
Yeah. Oop, we got touchy volume control. But you know I have a fix for that, believe it or not.
I have heard you through and through. But please have mercy on this heart of mine.
Well, there you go, Martin. What do you think of that? Your old grandpa's radio finally playing after who knows how many years.
If my darling.
Yeah, that volume control is definitely messed up. Has bad spots. Got to go almost all the way to the top before you get a good spot. Let's try one of the tone control positions here. Not bad. I'll tell you what, we'll just sit back and let Martin listen to that for a while.
In my dreams I see your face. It seems there's someone in my place.
I'm gonna check this out when I put my hand over here by the shadow meter. Maybe it needs to be grounded. Let's try it. Don't need to ground it. All we need to do is hook a gator wire onto it. What the heck happened there? I don't know. All I did was hook a gator wire on it. The other end's not hooked to anything.
try me one more time.
Try me one more time. And that's Ernest Tubb tonight here on The Legend, 650 AM WSN at WSMOldLine.com. Eddie Tudor on the lead guitar.
But what do you think, Martin?
Ernest Tubb guitar sound.
I think we did real well. I think that's cool. I'm glad you got to see it and hear it at the same time as I did and everyone else did. Fantastic.
Tremendous guitarist.
Of course, we got a lot of work yet to do. We have a lot of work yet to do on this radio, folks. We got to clean it. We have all kinds of things we got to do. I've got to check out each of the switches, obviously. Like I said, this switch is bad. And this one here seems to be working okay. We got a little storm in the area. I don't know if that's...
Well, it's hymn time this hour, and we're going to call on the Chuck Wagon Gang right now. The current edition of the group are going to be coming to the area working a week from Sunday.
No, just wait till another good song comes on, I think, and then we'll come back.
And I'll fly away to WSC.
The Chuck Wagon Gang. Not bad if I say so myself. Let's see if we can find something else. There's another one. I'm turning the tuner right now.
2013 GMC
Terrain and save
$7,000
on.
We're doing right now some
Bulgogi
glazed spare ribs.
Bulgogi glazed spare ribs.
So we like to incorporate some global. Anyway.
Advantage right now. When you shop online at advancedautoparts.com, you can pick.
Well, there we go, folks. I think we can go ahead and call this a wrap. Martin, I hope you're happy. I think that this is what you were looking for right in the beginning. And I think we've finally accomplished it. It took a lot of work, but we still have a lot of work to go, like I said. So until next time, this is John.